Now we go to the boost. Boost regulator. Step up. Here is its basic topology. There's a switch S. There's a diode D. There's our capacitor C. And there's our load. There is the current ID. And there's the current IC. So once again, we have two intervals here. The one is when the switch is closed. Once more, the diode and the switch are complementary with each other. So the moment that I close the switch, yes, it's closed, the diode is reverse biased because it will have a positive on this side and negative on that side, so it will be open circuit. So this will be mode one. What will happen to the load? The capacitor will be supplying the load through this whole period. When I close the switch here, current will be flowing into the inductor and the voltage over the inductor will be E minus zero, which is E. Okay, so that was mode one. Now let's go to mode two. When I open the switch, remember the polarity of this guy was like that. When I open the switch, now the polarity is going to change, positive, negative, but my VL is still like that. The diode is going to have a positive on its anode, and it will have a negative on its cathode. The inductor voltage plus the supply voltage will add together to forward bias this diode. So once the diode forward biases, then I will have the capacitor and I will have the inductor. So I'll have I out and I'll have out. Once more, as long as the current coming through the inductor is less than I out, the capacitor will be supplying the difference in the current. The moment that this current exceeds that one there, the capacitor will take up the difference and will be charged. The net charge and discharge of the capacitor in one cycle is zero. That means it is charged just as much as it is discharged. Therefore, this voltage stays essentially constant. And this is same principle is also applicable on the buck, but I didn't mention it just now. So now, what is the voltage over the inductor in mode two? Well, on this side is Vout. On this side is E. So it will be E minus Vout. Okay? So this will be E minus Vout, but it will be negative. Do you agree? Because the polarity changed from there to here, changed. And there, positive on this side, negative on that side, means a positive inductor voltage. Now it is changed, so now we've got a negative on this side and a positive on that side. So the voltage must be negative. So there we have the wave shape. Now if I show you this wave shape, although the I'm writing here now is different. What can you tell me about? What can you tell me about the wave shape of the current through the inductor? It will be exactly the same as with a buck, because the shape here is exactly the same. Constant, constant. Positive PIDT, negative PIDT, going up to a peak value. And I proceed. Right, that was the boost. Now let's go to the bug boost. Up, down. Basic topology. Once more, we have C, I C, I out, we have I L, we have L, we have D, and we have the switch. Remember what I told you, that the diode and the switch are complementary to each other. Now, I could have put the diode in here, or I can put the diode in there. As long as the direction of current flow is the same. So where do you want the diode? Here or there? Okay, I've made the choice for you. Okay, so there is I diode, I L, and there is I switch. Once more, the diode and the switch are complementary with each other. Therefore, when the switch is closed, then I will be putting a positive on this side of the diode. On that side of the diode, it just accepted that it is complementary. So the fact that at the moment when the diode the switch closes, the diode is open circuit. So now I have mode 1. In mode 1, the capacitor will be supplying the voltage to the load. And the switch will be supplying current to the inductor. When the switch is closed, the voltage on that side will be E, and on this side it will be 0. And we will have VL like that. So the voltage over the inductor will be E. And so it will stay until I open the switch. The moment that I open the switch, the polarity over this guy will be reversed. So now I'll have a negative there and I'll have a positive there. Right? What will it be? Well, the diode is now going to be closed. So the voltage over the inductor will now be equal to V out. But the voltage over the inductor is now reversed. So this thing here, the current is now going to flow like that through here, it means that the capacitor is going to be charged positive on that side and negative on this side, and that V out. So here we have the wave shape over the inductor. Has it changed? It's only the levels that have changed. So the inductor current will still have exactly the same shape. And remember we said just continuous. Just continuous. Now, so this formula stays applicable. The wave shape stays applicable. It is just the relative voltages that have changed. Now, how does current look that is not just continuous? There is current that is not just continuous, but is continuous the whole time.